You didn't have to fight the snow. You didn't have to fight rain. The birds were singing about 5:30. We don't need rocks to cry out for us. We say welcome, welcome, welcome to Christian Ministries Church at this Valley of Faith. Thanking God for you all being here today. The Bible says give honor where honor is due. We honor our pastors on today. Hallelujah. Sister Miller, Frankie L. Quinn, Pastor Lois Duck, and of course our fragrance of this house, Lady Quinn. We say to the saints of God, welcome. We say to the visitors, welcome. Make yourself at home. And just in case you don't know, this is a hand clapping, foot stomping, tongue talking. What's tongue talking? That's when God takes your tongue and has your tongue tell him that you love him in the language that he wants to hear. Hallelujah. So this is a hand clapping, foot stomping, tongue talking, apostolic Pentecostal church. So if you're looking for somebody to be quiet, quiet church is down the street. We came to praise him. We came to lift him up. Somebody said to me in the text today, I'm not going to be able to make it to church today. I said, I got you. I'll praise him for you. But put on my shouting shoes and lift him up. Why? Because he's worthy. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same.
In this church, the atmosphere is praise. We believe in God. Hallelujah. You woke us up this morning. We believe you, God. You started us on our way. Hallelujah. Let every heart pray, oh gracious Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we come before you, Lord, thanking you and praising you, lifting you up and magnifying your holy and precious name. Hallelujah. There is none like you in all the earth. The heavens declare your glory. And Lord, we worship you right now in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah, Lord, you're a way maker, you're a heart fixer, you're a mind regulator, and we thank you, Lord, for allowing us into your kingdom, allowing us into this place, Lord, to lift up your holy name, and we ask you, Lord, that you bless each and every request that's been made known to you, Lord. Bless each and every request, Lord. Heal bodies. Make ways where it seemed to be no way. Open doors where it seemed to be shut. Bind the hand of the enemy. Heal in the name of Jesus. Set free and deliver. Lord, now manifest your glory in this house. Manifest your presence in this place. Hallelujah. Heal our bodies in the name of Jesus. Increase our faith in the name of Jesus. Bless us, Lord, to walk by faith and not by sight. Save, oh God. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Deliver us from the hand of the enemy. And Lord, we'll be mindful to worship you. Bless us, Lord, to love one another. In the name of Jesus, strengthen one another. Bless us, Lord, to serve one another. In the name of Jesus. Lord, bless us to be persistent. Bless us, Lord, to have patience. Bless us, Lord, to sacrifice and to serve you in the beauty of holiness. And Father, bless us to love one another as you have loved us. And Lord, we'll be mindful to give you glory and honor. Now, Lord, take charge of the service of today. Hallelujah. Have your way on today. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost, you're free to move about. Holy Ghost, you're free to activate the power and the glory. Let your word rain down on us. Let the anointing rain down on us. Lord, destroy every yoke. Stronghold in the name of Jesus. Encourage us, Lord. Encourage us, Lord. Encourage us, Lord. As we fight the good fight of faith. Hallelujah. And lay hold on that eternal life. Father, we'll thank you. Cause souls to go down in your name. To be filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Come on and give God a praise. Come on, give God an expected praise. Come on, give God an expectational praise. Hallelujah, like you expect God to show.
change when you leave this place. Hallelujah, glory is gonna reign on your life. Hallelujah, praise your God in expectation of thank you and no more shock. Thank you, hallelujah, that I'm in an atmosphere where I can praise my God, that I'm in an atmosphere that I can feel the holy air, that I can worship him in spirit and in truth. Come on and give God a praise. Give God a praise of what he's doing and what you expect him to do. Come on and give God a praise. And come on, shout out of us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just tell somebody I'm expecting God. Hallelujah. Tell somebody I'm expecting God to move. I'm expecting God to open doors. I'm expecting God to pull down a stronghold. I'm expecting God to make a way out of no way. I'm expecting God to heal my body. I'm expecting God to heal my body. I'm expecting God to heal my mind. I'm expecting God to remove all the hurt, all the pain. I'm expecting God to open up new horizons. I'm expecting God to open up new pathways. I'm expecting God to open up new doors to greater success than I can ever imagine, to greater success than I can ever see. I'm expecting God to do the impossible. Come on and give God a praise. Give God a praise in this atmosphere. Hallelujah, where two or three are gathered in his name, God will operate in the midst. Come on and give God a praise. Give God a praise. He dwells in the midst of praise. Shackles are not loose. Hallelujah. Strongholds are broken. Chains are broken. Hallelujah. 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 If you need to forgive, forgive those that have hurt you. Hallelujah. If you need to forgive, release them from the debt. Hallelujah. So you can praise your God. So that God can give you what you need at this hour. Hallelujah. Come on and praise him. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord every night. I'm going to be reading from the 34th division of Psalms. Everybody have and say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Psalms 34. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. They looked up to him and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him, and saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him, and delivereth them. Oh, taste and see. That the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him. May the Lord add a blessing to the hearers and doers of his word.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Can we say praise the Lord, everybody? Amen. Thank God for the praise and the worship. Thank God for the service thus far. Truly God is good and he's greatly to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. Amen. He is greatly to be praised. And we thank and praise the Lord for our beloved wife, First Lady Tracy Queen. Honey, raise your hands, everybody. Good to see you. Amen. That's the good thing that I found. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We was in a seminar and the individuals was teaching about finding a wife. He didn't find it a good thing. Amen? And he brought that thing out. He said, men, When you're walking towards your purpose, amen, then you can find your wife. Amen. And then, before you know it, boom, you'll find your good thing. That stuck out with me. Amen. Thank you, Lord. So, brethren, if you want to get married, amen, start walking out your purpose. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So we praise God. We thank God for Elder Pastor Duck. Amen, Pastor Duck. Amen. We thank God for Evangelist Stephanie Arrington. We thank God for our deacons, Deacon Fields and Deacon Daniels. Amen. And our drummer boy over there. Amen. Yeah, amen. Sacrificing. Amen. We thank God for all the leaves. And we thank God for all of you that are in the house over today. Amen. All of our visitors, all of our friends that have come to be with us on today. Man, I feel like preaching now. Amen. Thank you, Lord my God. Amen. We thank God for you. Amen. We thank God for your dedication, your leadership, and your sacrifice. Amen. Amen. All right, now we want to turn your attention over to the book of Hebrews. I feel like I'm missing something. Amen. If I think of it, it comes to me, I'll stop right in the middle of what I'm doing and I'll tell you. Thank you, Jesus. Hebrews, let the church stand. Hebrews chapter number 2. Amen. Amen. Hebrews chapter number 2. I heard this message on not last Friday, but this Friday before. And then God dropped this thought in my mind. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Preachers inspire preachers to preach. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. In the book of Hebrews, chapter number 2. If you haven't, say amen. Amen. I just want you to read with me. Verses 1 and 2. Read. Therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip. For if the word spoken by angels was steadfast, and every transgression and every disobedience received a just recompense or reward. Number 3. How shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation, which was first spoken by the Lord and confirmed unto us that we heard him? And go to Hebrews chapter number 12. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter number 12, and begin reading with me at verse number 1 and 2. Wherefore, seeing we are compassed about with a great cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin that does so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. O gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you, Lord. We say thank you and praise you for the anointing that is in this place. We thank you, Lord, for your spirit that is here with us on today. We ask you, Lord, that you touch our hearts and our minds in the name of Jesus. Send forth your anointing, Lord, that makes preaching easy. Consecrate our heart and our mind in the name of Jesus. And Lord, you have your way in our midst. Save and add to the church daily such as should be saved. Father, we'll thank you and praise you and give you glory and honor in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Can't nobody Despising the shame. And the scripture says he was set down at the right hand of the throne of God, looking unto Jesus, looking unto Jesus. And the previous chapter, chapter number 11, is styled as the Hall of Fame passage of scripture in the New Testament about the Old Testament saints. And then Paul himself, who is credited for writing the book of Hebrews, thank you, Lord, he talks about the saints that ran the race. He said that they ran the race before us, and they literally obtained a good report from God by faith. The scripture says that faith is the substance of things hoped for, and the evidence of things not seen. And by faith, the elders obtained a good report. In other words, when they did the things and were obedient to the faith of God, they literally obtained a good report from God. It would be like God saying, "Well done, thy good and faithful servant, enter ye into the joy of the Lord." So you see, faith literally is essential. It's essential to obtain what we need from God in order to be a victor and not a victim. Amen. You tell your neighbor you need faith. You've got to have faith. You've got to have faith. And it's essential, amen, for accessing or obtaining those things that you need from God. Amen. In order to be a victor, amen, and not a victim. The Bible says faith is the substance. It's the essential producing element that we need to obtain the things that we hope for. Amen. A lot of people are hoping for some things, but the reason why they have not attained it is because they haven't had faith. But if you want to obtain those things that you are hoping for from God, you have to have faith. The Bible says that Enoch, he had faith, and he, by faith, pleased God, that he was literally translated, that he should not see death. And before each his translation, he had this testimony that he pleased God. Amen? Hallelujah. And when we seek to please God, and he says without faith, it's impossible to please him. And without faith, it's impossible to accomplish the things that you want to accomplish in life. Without faith, it's impossible to move mountains. And without faith, it's impossible to go through the necessary tests and trials that you may encounter in your life. But the Bible tells us we are literally compassed about with a great cloud of witnesses that live by faith. Hallelujah. Abraham, he lived by faith. Moses lived by faith. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, even Sarah herself, lived by faith. The Bible said that by faith, she literally conceived seed and gave strength. Hallelujah, to bring forth a son. And Abraham, he By faith he had the gospel preached unto him, and he was able to do and accomplish great things. Yes. By faith, Moses was able to overcome obstacles, even did not even fear Pharaoh, and was able to go to that mountain and to that wilderness, hallelujah, and see what he needed from God to order to accomplish the things that he needed to accomplish when he went back to Egypt and declared, "Let my people go." Hallelujah, you need faith, you need faith. Daniel had faith when he went down into the lion's den. Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, the Bible says that they had faith when they were thrown into the fiery furnace. These were ordinary people, but they had faith in an unordinary God. God is to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that you're able to ask or think. You too can do unordinary things if you have ordinary faith in God. Just believe that God is, and that he's a rewarder to them that diligently seek him. Just have faith. The Bible says that the trying of your faith is much more precious than gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, may be found under praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ. And my brothers and sisters, your faith is so essential to your walk with God that your faith is always under attack. The enemy wants to kill, steal, and to destroy you. How does he get to you? If he attacks your faith. Jesus told his disciples that the desire of the enemy is to sift you as wheat. But notice what Jesus said. He said, "I have prayed for you that your faith fail not." It's the substance of things hoped for, and it's the evidence of things not seen. It's by faith you can attain the currency. Faith is like a currency that you use with God to attain your blessings. Here, when I want to attain something, I go to the store and use my credit card, or use my cash, or use whatever means that is legal tender. But with legal tenure with God is faith. You've got to have faith to believe that God is, and that he is a rewarder to them that diligently seek him. And your faith is constantly under attack. Your faith is trying to be destroyed because the enemy doesn't want you to attain that what you need from God. That's why the Bible says, taking the shield of faith, that you may quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. You see, the enemy can shoot a dart of fear. He can shoot a dart of doubt into your mind and try to destroy your steadfastness with God. To try to tear you down so that you can believe that God will not help you and come to your rescue in your time of need. But those that have faith in God, they know that God is a rewarder to them that diligently seek him. Those that have trust in God, they believe that no matter what the circumstance is, no matter what the situation is, if God said, "I can," then I can. If God said, "Look to the hills, from which cometh my help," believe it or not, I'm going to look to the hills, and I'm going to expect my help to come. God wants somebody just to believe and to trust in him. The Bible says, "Trust in the Lord with all my heart, and lean not to your own understanding, but just acknowledge your God. Just acknowledge him in all your ways, so that he can direct your path." I feel a revelation coming on.
God just wants to be acknowledged. If God is acknowledged, he can go before you. He can lay the foundation. He can open up the way. God wants to go before you as a pillar of fire by night or a cloud by day. He wants you to be. He wants you to be your protection. He wants to be your shield and your buckler. He wants to be your supporter, your provider. So when it's all said and done, you can give God the glory. When it's all said and done, by faith, you attain what you had wanted, and then you give God the praise. You allow your light to shine and magnify the God of your salvation so that you can become a witness for the Lord. Come on and give God a praise. Come on and give God a praise. God is looking for some witnesses that will stand up before him and won't bow the knee to Baal, that will trust in the Lord, that will give him a ridiculous praise at ridiculous times and magnify the God of your salvation. I feel like preaching up in here. There's an anointing in this place. God is trying to elevate our faith. Let us elevate our minds and let's go higher in the Lord. Let us draw in our minds because God is about to send us a word that can change your situation, a word that will change your condition, a word that can open up the windows of heaven and pour you out blessings that you don't have room to receive. For the Bible says that he that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Let the church say amen. 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 Give God some glory. Give God some glory. My God in heaven. For God himself said in his word that we are compassed about with a great cloud of witnesses. In the scripture text, the witnesses of the Old Testament, Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac, and they all had a great testimony concerning God. And even Daniel, they had a great testimony concerning God, and they did some great things, but there's none greater than Jesus Christ. There's none greater than our Lord and our Savior. He epitomized faith. He was faith that came to us and was born. He was faith, and he healed the sick, and he raised the dead, and he spoke a word. He spoke a word by faith. He turned the devils upside down by faith. He spoke to the wind and to the waves and the sea by faith, and they all obeyed him. The scripture said that they, in the Old Testament, they all died in faith, having not received the promise, but they were persuaded, having seen them afar off. What did they see afar off? They saw Jesus. They saw Jesus afar off, and it couldn't be made perfect without us, but they declared plainly that they were strangers and pilgrims and sojourners in this world. They were looking for Jesus, and they that have that kind of faith, they declared plainly that they were looking for a city that have foundations, whose builder and maker is God. They were looking for the lover of their soul that would deliver them from the gates of hell. offering, when we offer up a sacrifice, that one day, soon and very soon, Jesus is going to descend into hell and lead captivity captive and give good gifts unto men. They believed that God was going to liberate their soul through the liberator, through the mind regulator, to the heart fixer, to the bridger of the depth, to the justifier of our soul, that God was going to send the peacemaker that would deliver them out of their circumstance. So the Bible said they died in faith. Oh my God, I feel like having a sidebar here. If you're going to live holy and trust in the Lord, you got to die. Trusting in the Lord, believing that Jesus is, I am the resurrection and the life, that he that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live, and he that liveth, let him believe that he shall never die. You got to believe that, yea, Lord, I walk through the valley of the shadow. Jesus, who's the author? He wrote the book concerning your faith. He's the finisher. He's the perfecter of your faith. Looking up to Jesus, who's the author and finisher of our faith. You gotta keep looking when trials have come your way. Look to the hills when you don't feel like moving. You better Jesus. When you don't feel like running, you better look to Jesus. When you don't feel like going, you better lift your eyes and look to the hills from which cometh your help, and know that all your help, it comes from the Lord. Come on and give God a praise. Come on and give God a praise. I'm looking to Jesus to heal my body. I'm looking for Jesus to open up new horizons and new pathways for me to overcome. I'm looking to Jesus. Your faith may get weak, but you better look to Jesus. There are many witnesses out there, but there's only one true and great witness. And what's his name? What's his name? What's his name? Jesus. Hallelujah. We got to be like Jesus. generation of sinners, lest you be weary and faint in your mind. You gotta consider him.
Yes, sir.
When he was reviled, he reviled not again. When he suffered, he didn't threaten. You gotta consider him. I'm done preaching now. But you know, when I was studying this verse, the Lord outlined the recipe for success. He said, the scripture said, looking unto Jesus, who's the author and the what? The finisher of our faith. Notice, this is how he overcame. For the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. Look at the victory. While he was going through, he didn't focus on the pain and the suffering. He looked at the joy. He looked at the joy. That's why the Bible says, the joy of the Lord is your strength. You gotta look at the joy.
By faith, you gotta say, Lord, you won't leave my soul in this hell. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You won't leave me here in this fiery furnace. Hallelujah. And then you gotta tell yourself, I'm coming out. Yeah, Lord. Hallelujah. I'm trying to wrap this up, preacher. Hallelujah. But you know, sometimes, you know, you think back what you've been through. Hallelujah. Think back about the testimonies of the saints. Hallelujah. Sometimes testimony service be so high. Hallelujah. Sometimes testimony service be so real. Hallelujah. Somebody will stand up and say, devil, you should have killed me when you had me. You just wait till I get my strength back. Hallelujah. Then it's going to be hell to pay, devil. Hallelujah. Because I'm coming back stronger. I'm coming back better. Because by faith, I'm trusting in the Lord. So I'm going to take my seat and sit down. But in the end, I'm standing up on the inside. Because greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. You ought to give God a praise. Paul was so caught up, he said, I'm crucified with Christ. He said, nevertheless I live. Sister Mama, he said, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. And the life that I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who died for me and gave his life for me. You ought to give God a praise.
He won't give up on you.
Yes.